Hello, I'm Orlando, and I'm with Tony from Singapore Telecommunications. So Tony, tell us about Singtel Electronic Mobile Top-Up.
Thanks, Oli. EMTU is our next generation electronic mobile top-up system. It's one of our key mission critical services for Singtel.
Right, so can you walk us through the architecture of EMTU?
Yes, we'll do. So we've built an AWS landing zone for EMTU, but the key design principles has been regulatory compliance. So what we've had to do was segregate the internal and external traffic. So here we've got the internet gateway, and this is our internet traffic. Over here is our intranet traffic. So we have the virtual gateway. Now what is these users is our merchants and also our mobile users. And within that transaction, we will go through a full route. For each component here, the web, the app, the database, strict regulatory controls are in place. When I say strict, it means that we've got the suite of security services, deep monitoring within the whole of the end-to-end architecture itself. So for example, within the whole transaction, there's actually Security Hub, MACI, we've got the endpoints, all looking at the whole end-to-end transactions. Within our internal users, we have Singtel management and Singtel support for the EMTU application itself. Here they look at the analytics, they look at the performance of the applications, and they look at the queries from any technical issues from our users.
Right. So since this is a business critical application, any potential infrastructure failures might run a risk of revenue loss. So could you tell us how you ensure that the application does not lose transactions or revenue in case of failure of some of these components?
Yes, good question, Oli. When we looked at the architecture for this, we obviously took into account the uniqueness of the EMTU application. So within the application load balancer, if there is any web front-end application failure, what will happen is it will fail over to the next instance of the web front-end. And that is part of our high availability of that application itself.
All right. And I notice another salient point here is that you are using the Amazon Aurora database as the system of record. Now, traditional telco mission-critical applications historically have always run on proprietary databases such as Oracle. So could you explain how and why Singtel chose to use Amazon Aurora?
Okay, good question, Oli. So one of the things that we looked at is a deep dive business case, Oracle versus Amazon Aurora. And the outcome of that was we had significant savings in cost, especially licensing. We had positive high availability from all our testing internally. We also had automation, because now we can automate a lot of the databases functions working with your AWS managed services.
Right. And the last question, a payment application will experience very bursty workloads during holidays and stuff like that. So how do you deal with that from an application and a data management perspective?
Good question too, Oli. So one of the things that we took into account is the performance of the front-end application, how far it can cater for high demand of the application. So at the moment, we can cater for up to 50 transactions per second. However, the average is between 7 and 10 transactions per second. So that's almost 5 times that we can cater for. Yeah.
All right. Thank you very much, Tony. That was a very interesting discussion. To everyone at home, I hope that you also enjoyed hearing about EMTU. This is my architecture. Thank you and see you again.